very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We are here. Very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We are here joining in from the Racecourse International Rugby Stadium for the finals of the Milo Knockouts tournament between Rawa College and AC Patana College. The evening filled with rivalry, the sun is shining brightly, and there's no any evidence of rain, although there was a bit of cloud in the evening. But the controversial game where there was controversial where AC Patana College requested the Milo committee to have the new have a new team. Rawa College Sports Complex, but now Rawa College has taken up the challenge, and the game will be played at Racecourse International Rugby Stadium. Today will be evening filled with rivalry, because you could see the both teams who have lined up for the school songs, which has been a tradition of any Sri Lankan tournament to have school songs played. If you look at the Rawa College lineup, and also I have alongside joining me, Akhil Yusuf. Akhil, what do you think about the game today?
Yes, Sajjad, it's a beautiful evening today here, and it's just a great atmosphere here at Racecourse International Stadium. The game between Rawa College Colombo and East Patana College will be played.
We are seconds away from the school songs played. We have Nicola Gunadura leading the Rawa College side, and Kushan leading as a center of AC Patana College. This also comes down to the rivalry of these two schools who has been who ended up as the finalist of the 2014 Milo Cup, where AC Patana College beat Rawa College. AC Patana College was under the captaincy of Harith, and then Rawa College captaincy was under Imshan Jayawardena. And also, if I'm not mistaken, we had last year's Milo Knockouts was between I think Science College versus AC Patana College, and now we have Rawa College and AC Patana College. So AC Patana College has been in the scene, winning the Milo single league tournament, and also runners up of the All Ireland Milo Sevens tournament. So I personally believe that it will be AC Patana College will be the favorite, but Rawa College has been, a team who has been creating some magic on and off the grounds, because the semifinals against St. Thomas's College was a great game actually, because Rawa College, who was beaten at the single league match, the Michael Gunaratna Trophy, of course, played with St. Thomas's College, and Rawa College. Rawa College managed to have a floppy first half, and Rawa College managed to have a rather deciding second half, beating St. Thomas's College, and also the quarterfinals. We actually need to talk about the quarterfinals, where Wesley College looked very dominant in the first 50 minutes of the game, but Rawa College came back very strong. The key players to mark will be Johnny the Dilshan, Nikhila Gunadira, and Uwin Eski, Ashok Vijayakumar. There has been a lot. And also, we have Kushan, the captain, of course, and also Sumudu from the AC Patana side, and also Chamod Vakisha. They are the players to look out for by Rawa College and AC Patana College. And we also can expect a fun-filled and also a rugby-packed afternoon here at the heart of Colombo, the race course. We are just seconds away from the commencement of the game, the kickoff. 80 minutes filled with intense and tactical games, because we have Niloufar Ibrahim and Henry Tavern from the Isipathanam camp, and also Sarath Martis and Dushant Liwake, who has been a captain of Royal College, who has been a legendary captain of Royal College, leading from the Royal College camp. This game of rugby having a lot of sacrifices by these students. Actually, these are not professional players or club level players. These are school rugby players making and sacrificing time and sweating a lot of blood, sweat and tears for the game they love. So these players have given out all, and then they come. For most of the players, today is the last day of their school rugby career, and it will be very dramatic to either go home as a winners or the runners up. You can see a good turn up of crowd at race course rugby, international rugby stadium, where Carlton Rugby Sevens was held with an international respect. So the school rugby players have been able to, although the controversy was about a neutral venue, although this players have got an opportunity to perform at an international venue. Akhilusu, what do you think about the fact that these players have gotten an opportunity to be a part of an international rugby stadium over here?
Well, actually, this stadium is one of the best stadiums I've seen in this country. It's probably the best, and I think the players will be very grateful for playing in such a great stadium.
But I've heard a lot of people say that this ground is very different, because this is very, very much equal to the international rugby grounds, and also the Milan tournaments were played at the Royal College Rugby Sports Complex. But the grounds will be very different. How do you think this will affect the Royal College Mall and the running backs of the Isipathana College?
Well, this is definitely a very much different ground than the ground we have at the sports complex of Royal College. This is basically a ground match for international standards. I think it's very good for our players, for the schoolboys to start playing right now in grounds like this. So it will be a good move for them in the future. Talking about how it will affect their game. Well, the Royal Mall, I don't quite think that the ground condition matters very much, because it's all about the team's bond and the tightness of the grip in them all. So, and for the backs, when we talk about the backs of the Green Machine and Royal College, it's basically, I think this ground will be easier for the backs, because this ground has a lot more moist and the grass is very fine and cut. It's going to be very much easy for the speedsters to move around. Adding more about the ground's condition to the pack, as this ground is very much evenly balanced in the grass, I think it will be a very good grip for the players to do the scrummaging and molding on.
I think, Akhil, it won't come down to the strengths of the teams, because these teams have been coming to the peak of the game match by match, from the league to the knockout tournament. I think it will be the mistakes and the weaknesses that has always been the changing point of any game, because the moment you make a mistake, and if your opposing team is a team who can take up the challenge and then convert that into points, I think that will be the biggest changing part of the game. Because I haven't seen, yes, the Royal College strength is a mall, but we saw the Royal College defense hanging up to the St. Thomas's College line and making sure that their strength of running with the backs and then using their wing three quarters doesn't work. And now we have the Isipathana College college anthem. And here we are at the commencement of the finals. And also the school anthems are done, and now here we are. We could see the both teams inside the huddle. Akiyusu, what do you think? Be honest about this game today.
all this game. What I can promise you is that it's going to be a tough battle between the both sides, the Tuskers versus the Green Machines.
And also to talk about the lineup, we have Nikola Gunadira at number 8, Harith Lokukamage at prop. We also have Malaysia Madhumevan at flank, Ashim Fernando at hooker, and also Hamza Riz at number 8, and also Sindhu Amar Singh back after injury, and also Ashok Vijay Kumar at scrum half, Owen Senia Eski at fly half, Tuleb Hassan at first center, Jani Diloshan at number 13, Nikhil George at number 14, Sabit Feroz at number 11, and Sachin Gamage at number 15, and also we have the Isipathana College. And here's the kickoff, Ashok Vijayakumar, and it's underway, and Ashok Vijayakumar puts a deep kick to Rani Dudushan, and there's Rani Dudushan, and he decides to go to the left side of the field, and also he tries to go through, and then there's a break point, and there's a short ball to the number one, and to the prop. It's about the college trying to use their strength, and we could see sending it wide to the wing three quarter, and then he drops the ball, and think that's an opportunity for Rock College, and the Rock College recovers, and the Rock College recovers the ball at the ruck, and then there's a short ball run from, and then there's a perfect ruck from Rock College. Ashok Vijayakumar sends it to Ayush Madhuranga, the prop, and he hits it hard, and Rock College gaining a lot of and there's a blindside ball to Nikhil Gundhira, the captain of Rock College. And there's another pick and go. And the Rock College has been working on the rocks, not letting Isipathana to. And the Isipathana having a good defense, making sure Rock College is on the back foot. Ashokumar sends it wide to Pasud Amar Singh, and Pasud Amar Singh tries to drive through, but the Isipathana defense has been working hard. And there's an inside ball to Ayush Madhuranga. Akhil?
And here we're playing. Raleigh is playing in their 22, a very tough battling game, playing close to the ball. High Rocks going dashing into the bottom defense. Bottom defense, they're doing it very well. They're staying packed, they're staying close to the rock. But here, Rock Hall is just a few meters off the try, off the first try. A few pick and goes done by Royal College. Very much of a tough match at the start itself. It's full of action.
I think this started from the Isipathana trying to run in, and there's Nikhil George here, and he's outside, and he has been put into the touch by Ranindu Dulce. Very good defense by, I think, Akhil Yusuf. This was merely Isipathana College mistake trying to work on their strength, but Isipathana College and Rock College, when I was talking about the weaknesses before, Rock College managed to work on the Isipathana College weakness. And then there's a line out, Isipathana College.
Yes, Adirshad, it's a green ball now. Jams. Oh, Isipathana doing a maul in their own 22. Oh, well, it's an unexpected situation here. And the ball goes to fly half to the first center. And now we see Indunian running, and a bit of handwork, and they've been broken down to 22. Again, they're going from the open side. Sumudra Ankot Gay going. Oh. And there's a breakdown in their 22. The Rock College defense are getting organized. It looks like Ismail's going to play with the pack as well.
Here we are all defending inside Ismail, and then Radha Dushan sends it to the Ashok Vijayakumar, and that was a rather good tactic, just trying to get rid of the ball, I think, and to reduce the pressure where they put on to themselves at the first few minutes of the game. Royal College ball, and we have
and now is the Royal ball in the 40 meters. I bet you this is going to be a maul by Rock Hall. It's going to be a dashing maul. And I think as well, Isipathana will be looking forward for a good hit. And they're probably aiming the players. And we see Azmir Fajruddin with the ball right now. Nikhil George at number 2. And Nikhil George takes the ball. And yes, it is a maul. The famous Rock Hall running maul. And Royal goes shoving. Royal shove. Looks like the Pathana defense has come up. Fajruddin being the tail of this backbone mall of Rock College, and they have, and Royal has the advantage. The referee's hand comes out, and Ashok Vijayakumar kicks the ball, and the penalty is given for Royal College. Royal College got the penalty in the within the first 10 minutes of the game.
The famous tactic of Royal College, and to gain the penalty to attack from, and Ashok Vijayakumar decides to take the touch kick to again. I think it's quite obvious because Visakhapatnam College has to learn that Royal College is anyway going to keep going. And then we saw Nikhil George coming back into the pack, and who is the wing three quarter? I think he's a good jumper as well. So I think and Visakhapatnam College should be expecting rolling ball and then keeping their defense low and tight, because we saw the Visakhapatnam defense scattered and all over, being in an offside position. So we could see a number two throw. Yes, and Visakhapatnam College and Royal College drops it down, and the mall has been set again, and the Royal College shoves, and then Visakhapatnam College keeps it steady, but it's no wonder it's called the rolling mall, because it keeps going. I think Royal College is advancing, and then they're 5 meters away from the tie, and the Visakhapatnam College working hard on the defense, and there's no advantage. And then we have Ashir Madhuranga, and then good defense by Visakhapatnam College. But Royal College may keep make sure that there's a perfect rut over there. Ashok Vijayakumar decides to go to the left side, and we have Harith and send it to Nikhil George. And Nikhil George is put down by two Visakhapatnam rugby players, and to Ayesh Madhuranga again. Solid defense by Visakhapatnam College, not letting Royal College gain any yard. And Ashok Vijayakumar probably should send it by no, and he decides to go again. And the first few minutes, the energy has been massive by Visakhapatnam College, but Royal College also has the positive. And again, Harith. Good defense by Visakhapatnam College. Royal College playing with their forwards. Harith and Ayesh, and then Ashok Vijayakumar sends it wide to Avinaski, and then there's a short ball, Nikhil Gunadhira, and Nikhil Gunadhira actually carried out, and then there's a ball, Avinaski decides to go through, but then he is tackled by Sumudran Kodge. Asid Amar Singh goes through, and then the Royal College players should support his. They decide to take the pick and go to the left side and to the right side again. And we have
the Royal capitalizing on the pack again. They're playing a tough game close to each other. It's like they're going dashing into the Patna defense, and the Patna defense is staying strong inside the 22. Is Vijayakumar again? Oh, and now Royal playing the short side, they're playing on the short, playing on their strength. We see Shefinaru, the pick and go.
Actually, there has to be a lot of credit gone to the Visakhapatnam defense, because they have been defending from the first minute of the game, having an Ashok Vijayakumar sends it to Hamza Riza. Hamza Riza sends it to Pasud Amar Singh, and then there's honestly no point in sending it to the forwards, because they haven't been gaining any, and to Azmir Fazuddin a role, and Ashok Vijayakumar, and sends it down to Ovinaski to Janindu Dilshan. Oh, he sends it by to Janindu Dilshan, and then there's Nikhil. Good defending by Janindu Dilshan, and also Sumudran Kodge. And then very well done by the Visakhapatnam College defense. Sumudran Kodge, the player we were talking about to look onto, because Sumudran Kodge having a floppy season last year, having an injury, is about to bounce back. Now, Randy here, the fly off, very good kick, but I think, oh, that's a beautiful kick. That's a 60 meter gain from inside the 20 meter to the Royal College half, and Visakhapatnam College, I think, will create a long ball from here. And we have the hooker. I think it's Kavisha Madhushan. I think they'll have a number four ball, and he drops it. And then we have Gunaratna, Omalka Gunaratna's brother, Devin Gunaratna, Royal College. And then there's a turnover ball, which has been the Royal College strength. And I think Ashok Ajaykumar should work on it and send it to the, because there's no numbers on the left side. Ashok Ajaykumar, good thinking to Ovinesky. Ovinesky decides to go on his own, but the Royal College rocks has been perfect because they have been. And then there's the penalty penalized against Royal College.
Looks like Ismail has got a penalty here in the 40 meter. And Ismail's going to take the touch. And let's see. Here goes the kick. Ismail that goes in the Royal 22. What it came from his father right now, all the way from there, just two kicks, and they're going to the Royal 22. His father packs, they're going to the try scoring zone. The Royal Tuskers are on their feet, they're going to pounce back in defense. The defense is well organized, and here, this father getting ready.
And we have the hooker, and it's a dummy, and well done by Nikhil George, and Nikhil George have been doing the hard work and drops the ball. And then there's a scrum ball to Isipathana College inside Royal College half. And this is the first time Isipathana College visits Royal College half. A corner scrum where Isipathana will try to dominate through their backs. We have Randy at fly half, Kushan. At Sumuran could get fly half and Kushan, and this we have and we have Harit Bandar, a youngster who is battling out, and then there's a collapse in the scrum, and the referee will ask the players to reset the scrum. We have the battle of Ashok Vijaykumar and Harit Bandar, the youngster from Isipathana College, who has been a part of the winning Isipathana College and who has obviously been exposed to a lot of experience. And Ashok Vijaykumar, on the other hand, who has been a star for the Royal College team, who has been a star to the Royal College side. And Harit Bandar feeding to the Isipathana College scrum. And we could see a bit of shove from the Royal College scrum. So, and then Harit Bandara sends Randil Shah inside ball to Kushan, and Kushan pops up, and then quick ball by Harit Bandara, he has to send it out, and then we have Isipathana College. Harit Bandara keeps on going just like we spoke before, and number three, the prop, the Royal College has to try and recover, but no, and then there's numbers, and I think this is opportunity for Isipathana College, and the Isipathana College is over to talk about the strengths, and here we are, the Isipathana College working on their strengths and running wide, although the first attempt of that was a mistake. Aki Yusuf, talk about this.
What a magnificent piece of rugby it was here. Sumul Rankot going over for the first try for Isipathana College. Absolute brilliant rock beside that. Absolute brilliant. He's been in good form so far this season. I told you right when the beginning of the match, the Green Merchants line is their armor. They have everything there in the line. And the Sumud Rankot Gays, they are scoring results.
But also to talk about the Royal defense was a bit scattered because they saw there was numbers on the right side of the field, and the Royal College defense did not work on the left side of the field, and then there was a gap opened. Now we have Ryan Vikramathilaka for that, which looks like around 28 meter to 30 meter kick. There's not much of a wind here at the Racecourse Rugby Stadium. If he puts this over, this will have a good first lead to the Isipathana College side, and we have a few chasers from our college down the try line, and Ryan Vikramathilaka. And I think he has put it, And he has got the 2 points. He has converted the points to Isipathana College. Although we didn't see an early try, which looked like there would be an early try in this game, we actually did not see an early try. The Royal College team has been down from 2-0 and Isipathana College 7-0. I think the Royal College had an opportunity to lead in the start of this game, Arke.
Yeah, definitely with the starting kick. I think Royal had a good chance to score in the first place. But now the game has turned over again, and now the ball swings back in the Patra deep, and he kicks. Asok Vijayakumar chasing behind the ball. And the East Patra attackers are charging deep, and Asok Vijayakumar kicks it out. But no, it does not go out. And the Ismail's running right around Royal College defense, and there was a good tackle by Asok Vijayakumar. And now the Ismail is forming their attacking plays.
And Haritha Bandara, he's obviously. And then there's a penalty against Isipathana College. The referee calls that Isipathana College has been holding on to the ball, and Royal College was actually very lucky in the Asok Vijayakumar. Randy have been kicking. He's the very first tactic of Isipathana College to receive the ball and send it to Randy, and then to either work it down the line or kick it down to the left side of the flank of the grounds. But it was a very good kick. But it going Asok Vijayakumar attempted a good kick, but which was a rather unlucky kick, which turned into the favor of Isipathana College, and then they tried to. A silly mistake has costed them. Now the Royal College line out. Azmir Fajuddin, we have. I think it will be a number 4 jump. We have Hamza Reza, and it was overthrown by Fajuddin. Haritha Bandara send it down to the right. Randy wide ball to Kushan, and good hands by Kushan, and he's gonna send it right. And we have. Gayan, the fullback, can send it to Kushan. Again to the forwards. Beautiful tackle by Nikhil Agunadira, keeping them down. But quick ball by Kushan. And we have Gayan stepping out. Oh, and he drops the ball. And Royal College make sure they. And we have a scattered defense. Asok Vijayakumar from the base. But Gayan, on them, there has a. No, they come back to the knock on, the first knock forward. By Isipathana College.
And now it's a Royal ball again in the 22. I think Royal is quite under pressure right now. From the first, they had a very good start. And then the Isipathana got into form and they started attacking. They started running right through their backs three. And now it's a Royal ball again. And I'm sure that all hopes rely on the 8. So they're talking about the packs. What do you think about the pack? I think Royal pack is much heavier than the Isipathana pack. And what do you think about the experience and how they play the game?
Talking about the experience, we have a lot of players from Isipathana College who has not been in the whole aspect of rugby, but they have been involved in a lot of weight training, obviously. And then we have the Royal College side, who has been in one of the top ratings in the when we take Ayush Mathuranga, Azmir Fajuddin, but we also have Bagisha, and also the legend Omaka Gunaratna's brother, the little Gunaratna, Devin Gunaratna. You know, it's Asok, and then there's Asok Vijayakumar decides to go on his own, but I think there will be an advantage. No, the referee does not give. And then there's a penalty. Then there's a free kick. Asok Vijayakumar might. No, Asok Vijayakumar takes the tap, sends it to Asok. Win Aski sends it wide to Sachin Gamage. And we have Sachin Gamage. Oh, what a tackle by Rani Dilshan. Royal College comes on the left side. Asok Vijayakumar, good cheeky kick to the left side of the flank of the grounds. And who puts the pressure off? We have Azmir Fajuddin and Hamza Reza, the forwards, who are the first of few players from the back to be there. I think a lot of fitness has been working on the Royal College team. Now it's the Oh, it's the we saw Sachin Gamage try to. I think he had a lot of space outside of the ground, around 10 meters, but he did not decide to do anything about it. He just decided to run through to Rani Dilshan, and Rani Dilshan absolutely scattered him. Now we have. We have a good number two, Maul Vaisipatana College and Rock College, getting a taste of their own medicine actually over here, but Rock College has been able to put down the. And Haritha to Randy, Randy to Kushan, Kushan sends it to Gayan, and then there's overthrow. No, and then. And Samud looks like he's Sabit Feroz and puts him out of the ground. Very good play by Rock College.
You see, sir, Dilshad, there has been a kind of a lateral play game here where the lineout was played in the 22 meters of the Patana half, and the Royals defense has been so impressive that they managed to get their own out in the same place. So we see how Royal interacts. Actually, there has been a bit of a ball mishandlement in the Patana line today. Why do you think that? Is it the condition of the ground, the humid, or are they? What do you think is wrong with their handling today?
Well, answering to the question, I think Patana has been sort of overconfident. A deep kick to Sachin Gamage, and Sachin Gamage takes it but keeps it on the safe side. And Sachin Gamage decides to go alone, and I think he has to be with his players. And then we have a Royal player on the ruck. Royal College did not have to risk it, but there was a Isipatana College, three players against one. And Isipatana College decides to take the long kick, I think. Is it a long kick? No. It's a very deep kick from Randy. We also see a few Isipatana players coming to the right side of the grounds. We have Sudhira and also Devin Gunaratna. I believe that Randy will put it into the right side of the touchline. If he says holding on. And then there's a deep kick. And that goes out from the sides of the try line. Actually, to come back to a scrum. I think the rule, that rule is kind of interesting in rugby. Because when it goes out from the touch line, normally they either give a scrum or they are asked for a drop kick. But our college, having the advantage of at least 10 meters, decide to. We see Thule Pasan and Nikhil George on the right side of the flank, and Janin Dilshan also. We also have Sachin Gamage. I think probably Royal College. We have a good shove by Isipatana College, but Royal College decides. That was a very good. Ashok Vijayakumar sends it down. Gayan Vikramatilaka takes it nice and clean, and he decides and sends it to Chamod. And Chamod, and we have Chamod chips it down. And that was a very lucky bounce to Chamod Gunaratna.
So I must say this match has been one hell of a match. We see the bombing up and down very fast on the ground today. I think this game has been a very close game so far, because both teams have had so many opportunities to throw their role and the goal half. It means that they have this minor in the game. So as both sides have this minor issue, the game is taking very close, and it's just the beginning. So what I can tell is going to get first half game is going to be a very decisive game. You know, this is the final of the knockouts of the President's Trophy. The last game for the season for many boys today. So රාකෝජී විසින් ඉදිරිගුණ දීලා අම්ද ඉස්පදන ටීම් එක අන්කොත්ගේ that's what I can say. This game is going to be a one hell of a game.
Exactly. Talking about the Sepatrakan is line, they have been a lot of things they managed to work on their strength, which obviously is one of their strengths, and there's a drop of ball, but the referee says knock back, so we college can keep on playing. And then there's a turnover ball, Isipatana. College gets it back.
Ashok Vijayakumar from the base. And sends a short ball to Chamod. And Chamod to Gayan. Gayan to Ranido, and he tries to go through, and then he's through, and we have Ashim Fernando. He goes in and out, and then Isipatana College has to bring in their support to. And he's and that's superstar staff work. Isipatana College keeping on to Mahima Gamage, what a try, and Kushan Singh Ranindu, and we have Thule Basan coming. What a lovely try. Starting from the left side of the flank. Isipatana College working onto the right side, and we saw a long ball to Kushan, and then Kushan, a short ball popped up to Randy, the most important part where the Isipatana College support has been constant, where they advance until the try. And
what a piece of rugby, what a piece of rugby. Those hands are the golden hands. That try definitely goes to history books.
To score one of the tries, these players must obviously have been playing together since when they started playing rugby. I think this moment will be one of the most memorable moments where they can, once they are out of their schools, if they manage to finish on top, they will have one of those moments at back of the table talking about this try. And we have Gayan Vikramathilaka for the conversion. We have at least a 35 to good 38 meters. Gayan Vikramathilaka having 100% conversion rate today. Gayan Vikramathilaka looks like he's over. Looks like he's over. And no, just a bit short from the goalpost. The Rock College team down by 12 points. We also have a Usain Bolt as the linesman of the left side, who is actually faster than all the rugby players over here on the grounds. And also talking about the Rock College, I honestly believe that Rock College has to work on their defense, because Isipatana has been working on the Rock College weakness. Every opportunity they get, the quick ball by Harith Bandar has been a vital option, and sends it down to Devin goes. He crawls through to Harith Bandara, to Randy. Randy is setting up for a deep kick to Sachin. We have Malisha Madhumevan, a good deep kick. What a kick by Isipatana College. Malisha gives Sachin Gamage. Sachin Gamage, a safe clearance by Sachin Gamage over here, and looks a bit unsure about his kick.
Yeah, Sajad Dirshad, looks like Isipatana team is controlling the game very well. It looks like the Royal Court players are a bit under pressure, which is especially in Mahima Gamage's kick, which we've seen him kicking way better than this in the previous games. It's time for the Royal players to boot up, because this is not a match.
We also saw a few unsure kicks by Sachin Gamage at the St. Thomas's game, and Sachin Gamage must obviously have some experience playing as fullback, because he was one of the best players at the Bradby. Scoring one of the two best tries, and Rock College getting a taste of their own medicine again, but Rock College putting Isipatana on their back foot, shoving hard, but it's Rock College managing to break the and scrum ball to Rock College. What do you think that infringement was, Akhil Yusuf?
Well, has quite a few scrums today. When we see the game as a whole, the partner players are capitalizing the game very well, and they're always, they had the position most of the time, and they're always in royal half. So then we see that royal players are lacking that X factor of their mind and their confidence. So I think is, this game, the finals, is not just another game where you can just play with your skill and your heart. It's some game which you need your mind to. Oh, is a panel is Pandan Khalid and they run with the ball. Quick hands, Kusha Andunil, run cut gay. Some of Fernand runs through and he's been caught and it's Kusha in the game. Some mishandling in balls and now it's a royal ball. Scrum down to royal ball.
Once again, we have the Isipathana College have been dominating the game so far. Although Royal College looked like this looks like the Royal College versus St. Thomas's College game, which happened back 9 days ago. I believe last Saturday, because St. Thomas's College looked like they had the pin in their hand, but Royal College tried to bounce back. But this also looks like one of those games. We can see Kushan and Sumudu, who has been a power duet in this game, who's pressurizing the young Royal College. But also we should be talking about the young Royal College side, because Kushan and Sumudu Randi has been deep kicked by Ashok Vijay Kumar, but they have not put out much pressure, because the ball goes out from the 22 line of the defending half of our college. The Isipathana College gets an opportunity to work on their strength again. Royal College should be expecting the running ball by Isipathana College, and we can see a good tactic from Royal College, bringing out Harith Dukamage, Ashen Fernando, and also Nikhil Gunadera to the back line. Free kick to Royal College. Hamza Reza decides to take the quick ball, but Ashok Vijay Kumar says, "Brother, stay back. I'll take this." Ashok Vijay Kumar sends it over. Nesky should send it to Chani Dilshan puts a little chip kick through. We have Gahan Vikramatilaka sends it to Chamod Gunaratna, first time fast. And we have Chamod, and he sends it. Oh, what a beautiful pass that was, but it was a bit high for him to collect it. But if he had used that opportunity, it would have been another try to Isipathana College. All the talk about the width of the ground, and which the ground which is bigger than, much bigger than the other grounds at in Colombo, we could see a lot of fitness coming into play at this game. Also, a very sunny evening, if you talk about it. It's actually a very sunny evening, at least 33 Celsius away. So a lot of fitness will be into play at this game.
Yes, looking on the ground, this ground actually has a bigger dimension. Oh, it's Hamza Reza breaking through, attacking the Green Army's defense. And it was Ashok Vijay Kumar, pass to Amar Singh. And he's been tackled behind the gain line. Vijay Kumar again. We can see some tough, ferocious tackling here by the Pathanians. Now it's Gunadir, the captain of Royal College, leading from the front. And it's Hamza Reza now, going alone. And there comes someone rushing in. Royal focusing on the forwards very much and going close to the game, playing close with the ball. Ayash Maduranga. Ashok Vijay Kumar is another box. It's between Chamod and Guy, and Guy kicks it, plays off. It's a high ball. Oh. And Royal have got a penalty after a long time in the Pathan 22. What will Royal do?
looked like Ashok Vijayakumar wanted to take the quick tap, but he stays back and he's going to go to the touchline and work on the ruling Mohal. Sipatana should be expecting this, obviously, because...
It's time again for Ayesh Madhuranga, Azmir Fajruddin, Nikhil Gunadir, Ashok Harit, Leok Gamage, Ashan Fernando, Malisha Madhumewan, Nikhil Josh with the part. Hamza Reza there in the behind the scrum-up spot. Royal line, fresh legs. Getting ready to run riots. Partner is... And it's a mall game. The ball is knocked on. Now it's green ball. We look like the Isabel have a good record in the defense of today's game. And Isabel has chosen a line out from the option of a scrum or line out. And it's Kavish again with the ball at the hooker spot. And a good contesting for the ball. But looks like the ball continues to be in the pocket of hands. And it's a knock-on. Royal ball again. Royal are retaining the ball in the pocket of hands. What can Royal decapitate from this moment? Royal has got many chances right now. It's time for Royal to pull their socks off.
I think it's time for Royal College to step up their game and actually put some points on the board. Because Royal College, after having the opportunity to be at Isipathana College defensive 22, they have not gotten the opportunity to get back in there. But now they are at Isipathana College's 22 for the second time. So I think this is one of the best opportunities for Royal College to step up their game, to work on their weaknesses. And there's a penalty. Ashok Vijayakumar takes the quick tap. Ashok Vijayakumar goes on his own and looks like he's over. This time, the player we were talking about, is it Harit Bandar or Ashok Vijayakumar? Absolutely, it is Ashok Vijayakumar. Here he is playing, having his day. Ashok Vijayakumar scoring the first time for our college. Having 12-5 on the board. We have Ovinaski who is ready for the conversion. I think Royal College has not really been out of the game yet. We also see that Kushan talking to the referee. I think it's about the try. Question in the referee about the try. I think the referee is sure about his decision. He has no mind to change it. Ashok, we have Ashok Vijayakumar, what a try. We have Ovin Aski. Bringing the ball at least 10 meters behind to get a better angle, because towards the try line the angle is not good enough to put 2 points on the board. Ovin Aski for the kick. And Ovin Aski, is it over? Looks like it's over. And then there's the 2 points. A converted try by Royal College, 12-7. And we have a game here at Race Course International Rugby Stadium. Looks like these two teams are up here, have been working months and months for this day. The Milo finals.
So just as I told, this game is a full contestant game. This game is one game where you can watch with your popcorn. This is a close encounter, just as I said before. Now it's 12-7, it's 5 points, just one try. The differentiates the green and the yellow.
And also, ladies and gentlemen, you can join in from MerckLive.com for all updates on Royal College rugby games, and Royal College, any sporting event of Royal College will be given live by MerckLive.com. And we have a short ball from the left side of the flank. We have Ashok Vijayakumar, and we have Pasindu Amarasinghe back in, who was injured in the St. Thomas game, who's back in action. Ashi and Fernando, and we have a solid scrum. We can see Ashok Vijayakumar calling out his players. We have Pasit Amarasinghe back again. There's a solid scrum by Royal College, making sure they do not lose the ball. And Ashok Vijayakumar kicks it down to, and then that looks like a very good kick. And then there's a cheeky bounce there. Oh, that's looks like a referee calls a scrum. Back at it, ladies and gentlemen, we have Royal College. Ashok Vijayakumar's cheeky little kick, having a little bit of lucky bounce, and then we saw Gayan Vikramathilaka, with Samud Gunaratna actually not having proper communication, which is a vital part of a final here, because it's a big final. So their communication they have to keep their communication right. They have to get their little points right. So their mistake, as I was talking about before, their mistake has cost a heap over here, because Royal College has got the ball and then they have the position. Their position, most important part over here is position. Ashok Vijayakumar and Hamza Reza. But Isipathana College has won the penalty. Although they had a mistake before, they have been recovering from the mistakes, proving that they were the single league champions of 2016. So they are not here to play half-hearted, and they are here to, I'm pretty sure they are here to give their heart out, because if you see the scoreline, it's 12-7, Isipathana College leading, and Royal College, although labeled underdogs, they only have a 5-point difference in this game, and we are close to the halftime, very close to the halftime. We saw a very good deep kick by Randy. Also, to talk about the fly half, Akil Yusuf. Randy has been, the only mistake which was witnessed was the first controversy where they tried to run the ball wide to the left side, but I think it was a game plan. But now he has been playing to his potential. His kicks has been great, and we have Harit Bandara to Randy again, and there's a move to Jamod Gunaratna, and it's true. I think it's true. It's Sachin Gam again. Kushan, what a try, and this is a sure try. And Ashok Vijayakumar is the chaser, but Kushan, straight from their homework, they have been working on this move, working on their Royal College defense, and then we had the first center drawing the Royal College first center inside, and we had the Isipathana College second center driving him back, and then we had Chamod joining the line, and after beating the Royal College first line of defense, and then there's the inside pass to Kushan. What a beautiful run by Isipathana College.
That try was a sensational piece of rugby, and we have Gayan with his kicks again now. From the previous two kicks, one was through and it was a bit short. Gayan getting ready for his kick. Right now the point standing in 17-7. And it's a true, and now the score is 19-7. And it's halftime. So at halftime, the scores remain at 19-7 with Isipathana leading.
Also, ladies and gentlemen, please tune in with Royal College, the MerckLive.com, the media unit of Royal College, presenting the live feed and also with the live commentary of the Milo Cup finals at Racecourse International Stadium between Royal College and Isipathana College. Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen.
I want you to breathe all this in. play pretend where the fun ain't got no end. Oh, can't go home alone again, need someone to numb the pain. Oh, staying in my play pretend where the fun ain't got no end. Oh, can't go home alone again, need someone to numb the pain. You're gone and I gotta stay high all the time. And I gotta stay high all the time. And I gotta stay high all the time to keep you off my mind. And I gotta stay high all the time. And I gotta stay high all the time. And I gotta stay high all the time to keep you off my mind. And I gotta stay high all the time.
To breathe all this in, breathe all this in.
Make one of the other.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We have the Musa Neutral Venue over here from joining from the Race Course International Rugby Stadium. And we saw a short kick by Gayan Wickramathilaka, the restart after the last 40 minutes of the game. Now this is where all the fitness works in, and Azmir Fajuddin for the line out. And we see a perfect number six row. Rocco is driving through the mall, but Isipathana College holding on at the defense. Asuk Vijay Kumar from the base to Chamod. I think that's a very easy bounce for Chamod. Gan Wickramathilaka to run into, and to Kushan. And Kushan should have passed it. It looked like that, but he's back. We have Haib Bandar's quick ball, but which looked like a flop pass. And he sends it. And he decides to go on his own. And then there he is. Ashok Vijayakumar on his own. And I think that's a sure try. But a try-saving tackle. But they're over. The Royal College defense has been scattering. And the fly half has scored the difference creating tie here at Race Course International Rugby Stadium.
As I told from the start, the pitch, the condition of the ground really affects the game. We see the speedsters getting a much advantage of it. And when we see about this try and previous tries, we see a lot of speedsters, you know, they cut through, they're agile, they're very, well, like people like Harit Bandar, Chamo, they're very much good in their feet already. So when a pitch comes like this, they become like their performance takes to next level. We saw how the sizes work here. And it helps Isipathana a lot in this game. And now we have Gayan for his conversion.
I think Isipathana College has created the safe difference they wanted to make. Is their constant try scoring by backs. We mostly saw the backs running through Harit Bandar, creating from the right flank of the Royal College defensive half. Gayan Wickramathilaka. Looks like it's over. And he has converted it. And we have a score of 26-7. Isipathana College having a 19-point lead at the Milo finals here. Isipathana looking a lot in the safe side today in this evening, Akhil.
Yes, definitely, Sajjad. Now we see the game moving more towards the green zone. The Isipathana team is taking advantage of the game very well. They're using their strengths. They're focusing on the weakness of Royal College. They're taking all for the advantage. They're playing a brilliant game of rugby today here at the Race Course International Stadium. And for the other side, Royal College, when you see the record of Royal College, especially against the Wesley game, they have a very good comeback, you know. They have strong comebacks, but we'll see. Royal College, I believe they have a very good comeback here because this is a match that both teams are very much determined.
But Akhil, Isipathana College is not Wesley College, Akhil, because we are talking about the champions of the single league, and then we are talking about the team, with all due respect for that team, we are talking about the team who plays last in that particular league. So we cannot expect a potential comeback by Royal College, but if they manage to score at least two tries in a margin of 10 minutes, I think Royal College could work out something. Ovinaski decides to go on his own, but he sends it back working to Pasindu Amarasinghe. Pasindu Amarasinghe and Royal College looking solid on their breakdown point. And we have Hamza Riza sending it wide. Good ball to Malisha. And we have a flop ball there. And Ashok Vijayakumar sends it again. His base kick to Gayan Wickramathilaka. And it looks like, and it's a penalty. Then we could see also the grand stand, which is creating a lot of shade
making sure that the ground is not exposed to the sun, which will also, although it does not look like it has an effect, I think it takes off a lot of strain off the players, because when the captains are ready to elect the side and the ball, they look at the sunny side of the pitch actually. So what do you think about this, Arke?
Well, to be honest, I really don't know how much sunlight affects this game, but you as a captain, I respect your game, and you must be an expert on that side. But what I can say is, you know, when just take your eyes a bit higher. Oh, and here we have Roy Moore dashing into the plus 22. The trademark working once again for Royal. Can they capitalize on this? Can they capitalize from this opportunity? And here the Azmir breaks off a breakdown. Vijay Kumar, George. Bit of footwork. And it's a penalty for Rock College. Rock College have a penalty. Ashok Dija should run with the ball. Pass to Amar Singh. Rock College have advantage. Referee stops the time. Referee stops the time. And it's a yellow card for number 6, Adish Virasunga has a yellow card right here. Now Royal again. See, Sajjad, you see this ground being of a very width and long dimension. What do you think? Like, normally when there's yellow card given and a player is sin bin, it quite rights for the defense side. But now here we see Isipathana with a player down. And this ground so big. What do you think, how will you think this should affect this game today, right now?
I think this should have obviously a positive effect on the Royal College side. They should stop working on their mall and then look on to their backs, because Royal College has not been trying to, maybe, and Azmir Fazuddin trying to grip through, but getting dragged back. Looks like Isipathana has recovered the ball, and Harith Bandar for the quick ball. Again, lost and Royal ball again, and then there's a knock forward. And also we see a player down. It looks like it's Devin on the ground. No, it's Kayan, the fullback, down. The golden boot, who has had 100% conversion rate, I believe. It's actually 80% conversion rate.
Having a small discussion in the middle of the ground. Game cooled down a bit, and there's a small discussion between the captains and the referee. Let's calm down. Royal ball. Set a t-shirt. Like, we've seen a lot of fly half play. And normally the fly halves are very dynamic on the field. They push the ball here and there a lot. And we'll take for this case, even SK. Yeah, he has been a prominent fullback in the previous year. Very good with his legs, good kicking the corner, good high ball catching, good passing the ball. When we see this season, like even this season, the first pitch, he was playing very well as a fullback. So now after he turned to fly half, we see a game where he is this fly half, which there's a loose ball. Mahima Gamage saves it for Royal. You know, coming back to our topic, we were talking about SK. SK has come into the first play at a pivotal point in the in game actually. We see him not very frequent with throwing the ball up and he either takes the ball and goes for hits. So what sort of effect do you think this brings on to the playing style of the offense team? Because they have anyway a heavy bat and they have Jan who is also a dash. SK being another hitter brings into this team.
I think honestly talking, Owen Askey is a very good kicker because his conversion rate, I believe it's 100% today. But I did not witness a lot of footwork or any sort of moves by Owen Askey or any sort of loopholes because we see the mall. So Parker is driving through. Looks like it's a bit on the Royal side and Royal side is advancing the Royal College back. I think they're over. Looks like it's over. Well, it's a penalty. It's been and it's a try. It's a try. It's try time by Royal College. It was a bit unsure, but Royal College has bounced back.
And so that is how we see Ajmer Fajuddin has striked again. Ajmer, the try scoring magician. The try scoring magician for Royal College. He has worked his magic again. Now Ajmer has kept another wonderful try in today's game. So now Ashok's try, Ajmer's try. Okay, both A's. I think A is working luckily for Royal College. And we have Ayesh Madurang with the A. We have Ashan Fernando with the A. We'll see how this turns out.
We're looking at that funny side. Actually, this is a very critical moment for Royal College because even though this conversion is put over, if we look into the real life situation, forgetting about the A's, Owen Askey with a rather, at least looks like at least Owen Askey. And we also have an A in Owen Askey. So if we look into the 39 to 43 meter kick, Owen Askey, is it over? And looks like, Owen Askey has missed it, which stands at 26 points to 13. Isipathana College having a double lead on Royal College, and also Royal College has because every time we look into a game, we see the crowd screaming their hearts out for the boys. Go Patana, go, go Royal, go! This is the spirit. This is where these boys having a brotherhood and putting out their passion for this game of rugby. The beautiful game. And we see a deep pick by Grahan Vikramathilaka, Ashin Fernando, what a lucky take. So Vijay Kumar, smart move to Sabit Feroz. Sabit Feroz, it looked like it was a recovery ball. Ashin Fernando being pushed by, it's a penalty for Royal College coming from the sides. Royal College should settle down. Ashok Vijay Kumar taking the touch kick.
Sir Dishad, I have another question for you. When we look on to the past matches, especially when we're looking on to the match, most of the matches in the knockout tournament, we see whenever Ashok gets injured, we see Jarendu taking the kicks. And Jarendu's kicks have a far more distance. Accuracy as Ashok Vijay Kumar kick. So, why do you think the coach or the team relies on Ashok's kicks more than Jarendu's kicks?
Because I really don't think I have an answer for that question. That's actually a question to be raised near the coach because we can sit down here and talk about the tactical methods, but these coaches, they know what their players can do and cannot do. So, I think. And also, Sarath Mart is the dream merchant. He has his plan, so we shall think here. And also, Ajmer Fajuddin going on to the hit, but losing the ball. And then there's a yellow card. And then Azmi Fazuli is off for 10 minutes and we have the Isipathana College yellow carded player, who the sin bin player, back onto the field. Now the pressure is back to Raw College, and this is just like a pendulum. The pressure, the energy keeps on diverging from one point to another, and I think that Isipathana College will use this extra man more than Raw College, because Raw College got a 10-minute margin to work on the mistakes, to get some sort of body to back into the game. But I think Isipathana will use this opportunity, because we could see a 7-player formation in the back line. So, and we saw a 4-player formation. Chamod coming back in, 3 players to tackle him. Harith Bandara sends it. We have Ranindu bring him, and Royal College ball knocked forward by Ranindu, trying to pop the ball towards his supporting player. But I think all the tries scored by Isipathana College were a masterpiece of their homework and communication here. I think Isipathana College has some sort of influence of the All Blacks team, because All Blacks team, every game, they have their offloading game going on where they continue their play. But Isipathana has some effect on that Raw College scrum. Ashok Vijayakumar feeding the ball to the scrum, the heavy scrum, which looked like, talking about Ovinesky, we see Ovinesky going back into the defense and being held on by, and ball back, cheeky little underarm pass by Ovinesky, and given to Ayush Madhuranga, and he's gonna bulldoze into the defense. But Isipathana defense has been solid. Ashok Vijayakumar sends it. Ashok Vijayakumar to Pasu Amar Singh, and I think Pasu Amar Singh, the talk about the offload game, and Shane Fernando, the lucky A, and Ovinesky. It's time to Ovinesky. Too much power on that pass, trying to create something. I think that Ovinesky puts his hand on his head, and he has made a mistake. He has gotten a chance, but I think Owen, and we also see Hamza Riza telling his player, this is your game, get your head into this, because we can do this. It's just 26-13. There have been teams who have been back from very, very critical games. It's up to each and every player. I believe Nikhil Gunadhira and Ashok Vijayakumar must back his players. He's talking about this Isipathana College, they have had Harith Bandara, Isipathana College ball. He's swinging in and out. Isipathana College is very settled down. We see Pasu Amar Singh trying to get it back. Good ball by Kushan. Kushan decides, and I think it's a very good high ball. Very well collected by... Oh, and he misses the chance to Kushan. But it looked like a very good chance for Isipathana College. Royal College, all the players, looks like they have given up on their game. That's what it looks like to us, but we don't know what they have in mind.
I think it's high time for Royal College to pull the socks up if they want to win the Milo President's Cup, because we see the game drifting more towards the green side than the yellows. So we have another scrum down here in the Royal 40 meters. It's a Royal ball. Ovinesky staying a fly half. Oh, and Isipathana has had a hell of a maul. Isipathana is playing on advantage. Sumudran Kodge with his powerful handoffs, working Kushan Indunil with the ball. And we have the ball again going to Adisha. Isipathana just showing how furious they are in the Royal College defense, breaking in like lightning. Quick on their feet. Oh, it's a turnover for Royal. Ashen Fernando. Ashley Fernando just broken down. Ashok Pujaguma. Malisha Madhumevan. Winaski. Roll is now near the 50 meters. Ispan is now playing with advantage. I think the worst weather is where people say a good defense is the best offense, plays Ispan very well. And there are so many players down at the corner at the touch line. Harit Bandar, the playmaker. And a George has been sin binned. Is the partner? With the sunglasses, just killing the players down in the field. Today, I think fitness has been tested to his brim. And we see many players who have been cramped. Even smaller players, raw players, they've been treated by their physios. It's a game that tests the physicality of players very much today. Because when we look around, when we look at the landscape, around the race course, it's, there's not much of cover. There's the ministry and Royal College, the college complex, the turf ground. See, so there is a lot of open space. So for the sun to come streaming in, the game is about to be resumed. It's a good kick. Patana come all the way down to the Royal 22 once again. Partner making opportunity to score.
And we also see a substitution. Nuan Jayawardhana for Malisha Madhumevan. Also Ayesh Madhuranga and Fadil Adahan. Two youngsters back in. We can see a crucial change in the Royal College pack. And Fadil Adahan tries some sort of magic to get the ball back. But Isipathana College is advancing. We also see Haritha Bandar and Royal College sort of destroys the Isipathana. We have players down from Isipathana. Referee calls Hildon in the mall. Isipathana ball. Which would still give an advantage to Isipathana College to further increase their lead. We also have a beautiful view of the stadium, filled with a lot of spectators, rugby loving parents and brothers and sisters and colleagues today. The Royal College defending with only five players, whereas Isipathana have six in their back line, which will obviously give a Haritha Bandar sends it to Randy to Kushan. Kushan sends it to Randindu, Ranasanga. And then there's knock on by where we.
Here we see once again how the Isipathana takes the advantage of the speedable conditions here. They're just flashing through the defense of Royal, running riots. Royal players have been foxed when Isipathana Kushan in the middle gets the ball. The game has been paused. There seems to be something wrong with Gayan, who's seems to have some difficulty with his leg. But the referee just, I think he has a problem with his knee, and the referee insists for him to take treatment. It looks like he has a blood wound. Another game back in the Royal 5 meters. And there's been a substitution here. another heavy forward coming for the Isipathan outfit. Lahir Uswajithi is a massive man. He's standing over 6 and weighing over 80 kilos. Right ball, Ashok faces scrum. There has been a furious change by the Pathan 8. And it's a turnover ball. Kushan Indunil. And Kushan. And Sumudh Rankotge scores. Sumudh Rankotge scoring try after try. It's been a marvelous piece of rugby. Sajadir Shah, I told you. They just storm inside. Isipathan using the furious fast. Isipathan just using the fast and furious centers to penetrate the Royal defense whenever, whatever possible. And they capitalize from every moment. Sumudh Rankotge with a marvelous try. He's also the leading try scorer for Isipathan team. After a floppy season last year, Sumudh Rankotge has come with full power, full force, full agility, full everything. He's been a powerhouse, the vice captain, assisting Kushan Indunil for this whole year. And now we have Gayan Vikramaratne for easy kick. And the kicks has been through. Isipathan with a magnificent margin now. Now it's 31-12. Isipathan with a huge margin. Can Royal come back? Royal is high time right now to come back up. We can Royal overcome.
And I think that Isipathan College has sealed the game today, 31-12. They have a very good day. They had a few mistakes in the first half, but although there were many mistakes, Isipathan College managed to work on their strengths, also capitalizing on Royal College's weaknesses, and they are back at their game. I should not say they are back at their game. They were in their game. Ashok Vijayakumar puts it down, rather a lazy kick to the good wing three quarter, puts a good left foot to at least a good 30 to 20 meters. And here we are, Royal College back. Having 15 to 20 minutes to go, I really don't think it is quite rational to have a good comeback from Royal College. Because if they have a comeback, that would be one of the biggest victories in the school rugby scene. We saw a little fumble in the line-out, but Ashin Fernando collecting it nicely, and then Royal College doing a few pick and goes from the right side. Ashin Fernando back. We could see the Isipathan defense working on their defense very hard. Harit putting a good pop pass right, and we see Hamza Reza being bombarded and pushed back from the gain line. I think that's what Royal's mistake was, not gaining. Owen Eski sends a wide ball again to Johnny Dilshan. I think this Sabit Feroz has been isolated, and he goes through. I think Johnny Dilshan has to support his player. We have Nuhan Jayawardhana, Owen Eski, Hamza Reza again being pushed back, because that was kind of a hospital pass by Arith Lokugamage. Royal College passing here and there, and two passes to Amar Singh, who is supposed to be a fast flanker. Sachin Gamage coming back inside. Royal College should settle down for a bit, and they'll turn our ball too, and then there's a penalty to Isipathan College. What a day for Isipathan College. The ground looks green, the Milo, all the Milo flags look green, the jerseys look green. I think it has been a green day today.
Sajid Shah, don't you think this is like the whole opposite side of what happened last year at the league finals at the Rockers Sports Complex, where Royal had an unbeatable beaten season so far? Isipathan had the same two, and then Royal capitalized on every single mistake that Isipathan did. And Rory was victorious. Now we see a deep kick. Mahima Kamage got the ball. And now he's trying to run with the ball in the roll 5 meters. And it's a line out. So we were talking about. The ball had. So far we've seen the ball is constantly played in the royal half with Isabella more than a 75% territory rate. Having a ball, Isabella are like the kings of today's game. They're playing, they're doing everything they can. They're swinging the ball, they're playing a marvelous game of rugby here. And on the Royal College, the other side, I think Royal College could have played a better game today. And that's when a small miscommunication by the Royal Pack there. And now it's Devin who has been stormed into the furious Royal tight wall. Try to break in to score another try. Vagisha. And now we have Kushan, the captain. Gayan has been tackled by Janu Dilshan. Kushan Indunil, Sumudu with a knock on. And now with the Royal scrum there. Ross playing a bit, I think Royal is playing a bit careless today at the end of the game. We see a lot and lot of mistakes by the Royal team right now. Like, come on, in there, 5 meters. Miscommunication is not something which any team would do at dying stages like this. And with the score, with such a great margin, I think they should do something about red, put the socks up or something.
I think it's a common thing to do with the score, because Royal College, when the score was 12-7, we have Nikhil George coming back from the sin bin. I think it's something to do with the score, because Royal College were back in the game 12-7, and then we saw two tries coming back from Isipathana College, and also the Royal team again having scored an unconverted try. I think it's something to do with the score, because there's absolutely no going back from that score. Ashok Vijay Kumar feeding in rather a good deep kick. Chamod, I think he's going for the long pass. And it's to Gayan. And Gayan gets his run into, and then there's a true. And there should be some him, Kushan. And then there's Chamod. And then there's a knock. Looks like a knock forward. And then, it's a knock ball. Ashok Vijay Kumar takes his kick. Harita comes back to the. It's a Royal College ball. I don't think Royal College would not be able to capitalize anything from this situation, because now we are talking about the score. Because Isipathana, although it wouldn't have been a part of their tactics, because it rather looked like it was a close game, but right now Isipathana are having upper hand here. Working on the famous back line, and Royal College trying to work on their famous rolling maul. And here we are, Isipathana College having the upper hand. We also saw Nikhil George come back into Royal College. And then there's a free kick mistake by Ashok Vijay Kumar, tries to go on his own to pass it to Amar Singh. The seniors of the side trying to lead. In this special situation, Nikhil, a good take by. And then referee brings back to a penalty for Royal College. I don't know what the infringement was. Referee calls Rai Vishwajit, the number 5, Ashok Vijay Kumar with the ball in hand, going for the. And what a surprising move, he gives Hamza Reza, and then looks like it was a dangerous tackle, but the referee does not have a look at it. Passes Amar Singh to Ashin Fernando. Ashin Fernando pounds his way through. Owen Neski talking about, sends it to Jandil Shan, I think. Very good pass. Sabit Feroz cuts it in. What a step in and step out. Oh, Harita Bandara,
Chamod, we can say Chamod. Ardhabandara is going to send it wide to Randy, to number 10. Ranhindu, what a through ball, and looks like Isipatana College has to be, and then there's what a try, starting from the 50 meter of Isipatana College half. Isipatana College thrashing the Royal College, and we should talk about Ranhindu Dilshan having two beautiful runs, just slicing through the Royal College half. What a beautiful sight to see today.
What can I say, Sada? What can I say? Look at these tries. Look at these tries. These tries are just magnificent. The spectacular piece of rugby by two great rugby leading schools today in the knockout final. We see tries beyond just what we've seen for the entire season.
I think we won't be wrong to call this an All Black styles play, because their consistency in play, because even though they're tackled, they are never stopped. They keep on offloading the ball. They keep the game continuing and flowing.
Yeah, I think we also see Sonobel Williams say with the ball going up and down. Here we see how Kushan Indunur passes the ball up and down with these marvelous offloads. And then we have Ma Nonu in Sumud Rankotge. And a nice Dan Carter in Guyan. That's a nice kicking accuracy. And there's a small Aaron Smith inside Harit. This is definitely the All Blacks night. Oh yeah, I think you don't agree with me on that.
I do not agree, but I'm just saying that we have been watching a lot of rugby matches. There's absolutely a touch of the All Black style. I'm not saying that they have been training. We could see a left leg kick and it's over. What a way to seal this try, Ranhindu Dilshan. We saw Gayan Vikramathilaka take the kicks from the right foot, having an 80% conversion rate. And then we have Ranhindu Dilshan putting this a very hard kick actually for a left footer. And he decides not to make any mistake and keep his team and to keep his team going. Which having a and Isipatana College very confident in running back. Passes Amar Singh and he fumbles it, but it's a knockback. And then there's a sevens kind of pass to Ashok Vijay Kumar. No, it's not Ashok Vijay Kumar. And then there's a ruck. Ashok Vijay Kumar. Royal players need to get back, not play tight with their forwards. They need to start running and put some points on the board. We have Harit. Harit Alil Shoyango. It's Royal College advancing to the Isipatana College 50 meter. Passes Amar Singh. Most of them playing their last few minutes of rugby. Very dramatic moment here. 40 points to 12. Ashok Vijay Kumar digging. And what a surprising through ball for Amaris. The cutting through just looks like Royal College. No, it's a penalty. The referee calls. Not staying on his feet, actually. Ashok Vijay Kumar decides to go to the touchline, but I don't think even if Royal College gets back with three tries, it will have an effect on the game.
Well, in the dying moments of an incredible game of rugby, which I think it's not wrong if I say this game was more of a one-sided game, especially in the second half. They were out in their 100%. They just gave everything out. They trained for the last maybe 6, 7, 8 months, all out whatever they had in today's game, because there will be nothing they have after today's next 5-10 minutes, and they haven't ever they left nothing else to regret. This is I think Nilfa Ibrahim has done some nice work with the lads from the Havelocks. And it's a Royal ball again. Royal is going on PGs. Ashok Vijay Kumar. Arsene Fernando will be struck by two heavy forwards of the green machine. And there comes Tulev Hassan strolling in. Janu Dilshan, the furious back. And now we have Savit Feroz running right again, running cross all the way inside. And there's a turnover with Kushal Indunil, the captain. Oh, no, it's a penalty for our college inside the 22 meters of the Ispatan territory. Asek Vijayakumar with the ball. Will he take the 3 points or will he go for a corner? Oh no, he runs with the ball. A change of plans. SK. Passing to Amazon. He cuts in and it's a knock on. Lots of mishandling by Royal Studio. I think Royal. Would you agree with me if I say Royal has already given up in the game? Because we see mistakes running here and there. We see mistakes in their own 5 meters.
Is that even a question, actually? It's not the fact that Royal College team has given up, but the scoreline has made them given up because the scoreline looks massive, 40 to 12 points. What does it look like, Akhil Yusuf? And we see a change. We have 4 changes from Ispatan College, proving that even the bench, the substitutes, has the potential to outrun this the passionate Royal side. Royal side, anyway, who were underdogs and Ispatan College favorites. And then in the 9 minutes of these moments of these players, the seniors who has been working very hard for these moments, and then it's honestly a very sad view for the Royal side. But I think they have enjoyed the rugby life they have lived.
It's for the working on the blind side, break into dashing. Here goes someone just sprinting through the ground. Running to sprint into the ground, and there is George running behind him and running to with the under the post try to seal off the game for Ispatan College. What a magnificent try that was! Perfect, just extremely perfect.
I think I was right to tell that the grass looks green, the mile packets look green, the sponsors look green, everything looks green for Ispatan College. Royal College did not get the opportunity to. And it was raining green today. The tries were actually raining green. 45 points to 12. And it looks like a T20 score. Looks rather like that. And also running the scoring the try and going for the conversion. And we could see the firecrackers go off. It looks like it's game over for Royal College and Ispatan College. Has got what they deserve. They have played their hearts out. Does this mean that the game is over? And it's over! Ispatan College celebrating the champions of Milo Cup Finals 2016. Congratulations, Ispatan College.
Yes, sir. This is green, and green. It's really green evening today at race course. Ispatan College, last year runners-up and knockouts, this year winners-up knockouts. What a performance. What about double champions this year? Double champions, they won the league, they won the knockouts, they were the runners-up in the sevens. What a year for Ispatan Rugby today. They have made just history, Ispatan Rugby. The green machine led by Kushan Indunil and his partner Sumudra Ankotge. They have indeed made a year for Ispatan, remember, for the years to come. Unbeaten league champions. And here we have Kushan Indunil running around with the Ispatan flag. And the spectators, the schoolboys, full of joy here in the green lads. It's definitely Ispatan night, Pathanian night.
It looks beautiful indeed to look at this crowd. This is Ispatan College crowd. We also see Kushan, obviously a very happy captain who has led this team, not also led this team, who has also created tries and also points for his team. As a captain, it's not the most important part is not only leading the team but also making a positive effect on the
team.
My friend,
players have given the
We should be able to bounce back, but for now, Isipathana College will remain the 2016 Milo President's Trophy Champions 2016. A very marvelous view indeed. And we could see them yell in the middle of the course, also known as a controversial neutral venue.
What a wonderful game it was. I think the X Factor.
Who has been working very hard in and out, who has been there for every game. So right now, signing out, Sajjad Irshad and
Akhil Yusuf. Thank you. Good night.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.